Hello, my cookies. Today we are making some good old country fried steak and gravy. Let's cook. Starting with the steak, I'm using cube steak, which is very affordable, and essentially it's just round steak that has been tenderized. And I'm going to season both sides of my cube steak with some seasoning salt. Now let's set that aside and work on our breading station. We're going to start with some all-purpose flour. To that, I'm going to add onion and garlic powder and also some accent. I know y'all get all upset when I use accent because of the MSGs. If you don't want to use that, just use some salt. Now on a separate shallow dish, we're going to add some eggs, two of those, and some milk. And then just whisk that together well. Now we're gonna start breading. We're gonna start off in the flour, coat both sides well, and then switch over to the egg mixture, coat both sides, and back into the flour. And we're gonna do this for all of our steaks, then set them aside. Now heat some canola oil in a pan over medium-high heat, and we're not gonna deep fry these, so just use only enough oil to coat the bottom of the pan. And now we're gonna add our steaks in, and we're gonna allow them to cook for 4 to 5 minutes, just until the steaks are golden brown on each side. When the steaks are done, remove them, and in that same pan with the drippings, add some butter. When the butter melts, we want to whisk in some all-purpose flour. Then we want to pour in some chicken stock and milk while whisking. Allow it to come to a simmer and thicken, and then we just season it with a little salt and pepper to taste, and that is it for our gravy. Once it's thick, it's ready to serve. And cookies, that is it for our country fried steak and gravy. The recipe link will be down there in the description box. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, give me a thumbs up. Until next time, be blessed.